This is great. Oh, I love it. I love it, dude. Oh, man. The sky, the air, the breeze. I'm just so thankful for it all. Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, oh man. Oh, man. Oh, man. Whoa. Hey there, Jack. What's the matter? Oh, man. Oh, man. I just am having one of them days. Oh, nothing seems to be going right. And I just... Man, oh man, oh, sorry there, dude. What seems to be the trouble? Well, you know, everything just seems to be going wrong, and, you know, it's too hot, and it's just tiring, and there's just nothing going right. Oh, dude, I'm sorry. I hate when things don't go right, but, you know, you can still be thankful even when things aren't going right. Be thankful? What? Shoo-wee, man, I can't be thankful when there's stuff not going right. How am I supposed to? I'm only thankful when things are perfect, when I have everything going just perfectly, you know? Well, Jack, that would be impossible then, because nothing ever goes well. Perfectly? Well, you know what I mean. I just want everything to go right for once. I feel like everything goes wrong in my life. My hay is all mushy, and you know, the sky, it's just so hot out. I'm just having a rough day. I just wish I had a better life. You know what I'm saying? Well, Jack, I think you just need to chill out, dude. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's just, you gotta think about all that you do have, you know? Yeah, like, you gotta see this beautiful scenery. You gotta see all this wonderful gifts you've been given. Gifts? What gifts? I don't got no gifts. Who, is it your birthday or something? No. Jack. What I'm trying to say is everything's a gift. I mean, just look. You have life, you have food, you have friends like me, right? Oh, well, yeah, sure, George, but... Well, then you have enough to be thankful for, dude. It's great. You gotta look at life as things that you got, not things you don't got. And think about all the gifts that you don't even deserve, like this wonderful weather and the food you have. It's just the things you have are gifts. Huh. Well, ain't that something? Everything I have is a gift. Well, shoo-wee, but wait.
What?
Who gives all these gifts? If it's a gift, who's giving it to me?
Well, who do you think, Jack?
Oh, I think I'm beginning to understand now. God, right?
Exactly. See, when we see what all the gifts we have and know that God's given them to us, we can be thankful.
Oh, man, that's great. I should be thankful. Let's think about all the things I can be thankful for. Let's see. I'm thankful for my hay and for oats. I'm thankful for the weather, the sky, the sun, the moon. I'm thankful for my friends. I'm thankful.
Yeah, man. Keep it going.
All right, let's see. I'm thankful for this piece of wood here. I'm thankful for the ceiling.
Okay.
Hey kids, how are you? I hope you had a great day today. Isn't it amazing how we went through all of this awesome prayers, all these prayers about the exile, and how we went through all these different ways to pray, and last week we were celebrating. It was so much fun, right? So we went through those prayers of happiness and of sadness, of repentance, and of actually thinking about how do we pray together, and then finally thinking about celebrating, the prayer of celebration. It's so much fun, and it's so awesome to be able to celebrate. Even where you are, even what's happening around us, we can still celebrate. Well, hey, we are now going to move into a whole different series now. It's becoming that next month, which is November, right? And in November, we have this holiday that comes up every year. We eat turkey, we enjoy mashed potatoes maybe, all that good food. But in case you didn't know, Thanksgiving is really so much more, right? We can be thankful for so many things. And what happens? What happens in life? Like we were talking about those prayers in the exile, we can easily let the things around us, the things that are happening, make us feel so down and sad, or we just get like, just like Donkey, right, Jack? He just felt like, nothing's going right. I don't have what I want, so I can't be thankful. But guess what? No matter what the circumstances are in our lives, we can still be thankful. You can still be thankful. We give thanks to the Lord no matter what. So we are going to be looking at different stories and different passages in the Bible all about being thankful. But really, it starts with what? Who are we giving thanks to? You know, we think about this in Thanksgiving. Oh, we are so thankful for our friends and for our family and for food and all these different things that we have. And sometimes we just like to think of it as like, oh yeah, let me think of all the good things in life. But are we really being thankful? Because being thankful means you're actually saying to someone, thank you. Well, who are we ultimately thanking for all these wonderful gifts? God. It's such a good thing to be thinking about. How am I being thankful, not just to my mom and dad or other people, but being thankful by thanking the Lord who ultimately gives us every good gift? We are going to be looking at this verse this period of time during this November period, and we're going to think about this verse every time we come together. So we're going to use some motions. So stand up. We're going to do a little motions to help us remember this verse. Praise the Lord. So put your arms up. We're going to praise the Lord. Do it with me. Praise the Lord. Then it's, oh, give thanks. So praise the Lord. Oh, give thanks. Right? So arms up. Make a big O and then give thanks. Who? Again, to the Lord. So praise the Lord. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Thumbs up. Let me see it. For he is good. Then the last part. Why is he so good? Because for his steadfast love endures forever. His steadfast love endures forever. Do this with me one more time. Arms up. Praise the Lord. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. That's found in Psalm 106. But guess what? In that book of Psalms, which is a big book of poetry and songs, there are so many verses about being thankful. In fact, this verse, give thanks to the Lord for he is good, is found so many different times. So we're probably going to look at a little bit from Psalms, but then see different stories in the Bible that help us to realize how wonderful it is to give thanks. Because guess what? When our hearts want to grumble and complain, oh, I'm not getting my way, oh, things aren't going well, we want to complain. Guess what the best remedy for that is? Giving thanks. And so this time during November, I hope that our hearts will be very open and soft to what the Lord wants us to teach us about being thankful. So I'm going to pray for us now, and hopefully I will see you in all these weeks in November leading up to that holiday, Thanksgiving, and thinking every time we get together, how do we give thanks to the Lord? So let's pray. Lord God, thank you for who you are. Thank you that you're a wonderful God, that you are good, and that your steadfast love endures forever. Thank you, thank you, thank you for all the many gifts we have. Father, sometimes we don't think about all the good things we have. But I thank you for our friends and for our family, for the food we have, for the times we have to be able to come together and worship you, for the things in this world, like school even, and things that sometimes we take for granted. We don't think they're very important until like these times when suddenly things are so different. We do recognize how important they are. And so we want to give thanks for all of these things. Lord, thank you for each child who's watching. And I pray that you, Lord, will work in their heart a heart of thanksgiving, a heart that truly understands everything in their life is a good gift from you. We praise you and thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. I'll see you next week, guys.